Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Franny, and for today's Vlogmas video, I have the Joy of Christmas book tag. Anticipation. The Christmas excitement is real. What book release or releases are you most anticipating? There are two books coming out next year that I'm highly, highly anticipating. The first one comes out in April and is The Spectators by Jennifer Dubois. Now, this book has a very complicated synopsis. Basically, it is set in the 70s or 80s or something like that, and the main protagonist is a talk show host. He uncovers scandals and stuff about famous people, but he's very secretive about his own life. But then a mass shooting happens, and as it turns out, the people responsible for that mass shooting are fans of this talk show host. There are going to be investigations and secrets coming to the surface, and this book has a lot going on, and all that lot appeals to me, so I cannot wait. And the other book is With the Fire on High by Elizabeth Acevedo. This book comes out in May, and it is about a girl who got pregnant either in high school or the first years of university, so she dropped out, and now she wants to become a chef. I don't know what it is exactly, but the synopsis of this book speaks so much to me. Perhaps it might be the chef thing going on. This author has also written Poet X, which I haven't read, but that one was in verse while this one is in prose, and I get along well with prose, and the same cannot be said for verse, unfortunately, so I have high hopes for this one. Christmas songs and carols. What book or author you can't help but sing its praise? Let's see, Patrick Ness, Aidan Chambers, Brennan Sanderson. Gingerbread Houses. What book or series has a wonderful world building? Huh, I wonder what and who. I cannot really think of any. I guess I'll skip this one. A Christmas Carol. A favorite classic or one that you want to read? So, favorite classic, I think The Secret Garden by Frances H. Burnett, because I just love that book so much. It's one of my favorites from childhood. I just love it too much. And for a classic that I would like to read, lately I've been wanting to read Paradise Lost, but it's in verse, and I really don't like reading stories in verse. So I want to read it, but I'm conflicted. Have you guys read it? Do you think I should? Just let me know. Christmas sweets. What book would you love to receive for Christmas? I have said this already, but I plan on doing a video about books that I would like to find under my Christmas tree. I'm not gonna spoil that video for you, so you will have to wait to find out. I am such a tease, aren't I? Candles in the Window. What book gives you that warm, fuzzy feeling? Winnie the Pooh, definitely. I saw the movie last week and just, it made me cry, it made me feel all the warmth and the adorableness. Is that even a word? I don't know, but it made me feel all the feels, and it was just so beautiful, and I loved it so much, and so I immediately went and picked up the book, and it just gave me the same feelings, and I love it so much, so Winnie the Pooh. Christmas tree and decorations. What are some of your favorite book covers? I chose three. They are all just gorgeous. Born a Crime by Trevor Noah. I just love how there's a graffiti of his face on the cover instead of his actual face, and the colors are just so beautiful, and he's so handsome, and I just love this cover so much. Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close by Jonathan Safran Foer. Usually I don't love people on covers, specifically people's faces on covers. It's not something that I usually like, but in this case, I just love what they did and the text, how they placed it, and the eyes of the kid are so expressive. I just love it. And The Chimes by Anna Smail. There's both visual and musical harmony on this cover. I love the colors that they used. I love how they blend in with each other. I love that they used the treble clef for the cover. I love everything about this cover, and I really need to get to this book. And also to Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close, because I've only read Born a Crime among these, and that's not okay. Christmas Joy! What are some of your favorite things about Christmas and some of your favorite Christmas memories? Favorite things about Christmas? Christmas food? Definitely. I don't know how it is around the world because I've never celebrated Christmas outside of Italy, but here in Italy we have specific food and meals and dishes that we cook for Christmas, and we only have those foods during the Christmas time, which makes them all the more unique and so good, and I love them. And I want to make a video about what we have on Christmas, you know, on Christmas Eve and the Christmas Day and so on. I hope that I'll be able to do that because I want to share it with you guys. And also I love putting up the Christmas tree and the Christmas decorations, and then I love to go outside and just be surrounded at night by Christmas lights twinkling, and I just love everything about Christmas. I love the spirit of Christmas. I just love everything. I love everything about Christmas. And for the Christmas memory, but okay, so during the Christmas holidays, specifically on Christmas Day and during the first few days of January, you know, when the Christmas holidays are about to end, we play board games. They're not your usual typical board games. They are kind of board games that you play with cards, or an Italian version of bingo that you only play during the Christmas time. And now it has become more of a tradition, I guess, but when I was younger, we really didn't get to play a lot because adults didn't like it. But there was an uncle of mine that now has passed away, unfortunately, and every year after the Christmas lunch that lasted for hours, he was the only one that sat at the table ready to play games, and he helped me convince the others to sit down and play games with us. And he mainly did it for me because I'm the youngest in my family, and that was very nice, and it's a memory that I cherish very much. And I also love the smell of Christmas because in my family we cook a lot. We usually cook a lot, but on Christmas, it's taken to the next level. And so on Christmas Eve and on Christmas Day, we're cooking so many things, and there's a smell in the house that's just the most wonderful thing in the whole world. And when I was younger, I just stood there, you know, looking at the adults while they were cooking. But now that I'm old enough and that I know how to cook, I help them out, and it's just incredible. I love it. I love cooking Christmas food. It's the best. I love everything about Christmas. I just love it. Okay, so this is it for this tag. I hope you guys enjoyed watching, and I'm going to tag some people to spread the Christmas spirit and the Christmas love. I'm going to tag Marisa at LittleSpider9, Matthew at MCS Books, Emily Cait at Emily Cait Reads, Emily at Possibly Lit, and Annie at Am I Right? I really hope you guys will do this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching it. If you want to do this tag and I haven't tagged you, please do and let me know in the comments so I can come and check your video out. Or if you want to reply to these questions in the comments down below, you can totally do so, and I would love to read your answers. This is all for today. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow with another Vlogmas video. Warm hugs.